What's up, y'all? This is Henny. And listen, today I want to come real quick and just have a quick discussion about where the music production game is going and what we can see in the future. I recently watched a video by Omar Gonzalez talking about, are the new cameras, you know, lifeless? Are they too pristine? Do they not have enough character? And I've been thinking a lot about that as it relates to audio and music production. And even my whole journey when it comes to, you know, my career as a music producer and where are we going with audio and music production in the future. Let's talk a little bit about that real quick right now. Let's go. The business. So I know a lot of you have been asking, you know, where is the music content? Where is the music production content on your channel right now? And to be honest, you know, I've been messing with iOS music production for years and I've, you know, I take time out and sometimes I am not as inspired as I've been over the past. And I know many of us feel that. It's not necessarily always burnout, but sometimes you just you're being creative in other ways. And, you know, I knew I always wanted my channel to be based off of the things that I'm into and how I can bring it back to this community. Because like I've said before, community is really everything when it comes to YouTube. But when we talk about audio production, music production, where are we going? You know, I look at like, you know, the last 10, 15 years of the progression of music production where I remember starting out and I just had, you know, the SR10 and rack models and Big Sense and, you know, a lot of things that were definitely not mobile and, you know, were very expensive at the time. Then to dive in more into the digital space where I started using, you know, Reason, to using Pro Tools as a DAW, to using Logic as a DAW, all the way up until I started to dive into Ableton and other things like that. I know everybody who's been on music production journeys, they probably have similar experience trying new DAWs and figuring out new things. And it's funny how, you know, in Omar's video, he talked about a lot of the character that was missing in a lot of cameras because, you know, they're so good. They're so clear. The megapixels are so high. And I think that I thought about that with audio production, how, you know, over the last 15, 20 years, we've been really trying to get to more of an analog sound. You know, you can see the things that Universal Audio are doing, the things that, you know, Apogee are doing, the things that IK Multimedia are doing, Native Instruments are doing. A lot of the things are trying to get back to that vintage analog warm sound. And I've seen a lot of it translate into iOS music as well with, you know, some of the simulations and the tape saturations and the things that, you know, we want to have to give us a more of a lo-fi sound when it comes to music production. I think one of my issues is trying to figure out where we're going next. And I've always wanted to be on the cutting edge of the things that, you know, I'm about. And I love latest tech. I love, you know, the new gear. I love to see where things are going. And I want to pose a question to y'all. Where do you think, you know, audio production is going? A lot of times I use the tech to really get me inspired, to create new things, to create new art, whether it's music, video, whatever I'm doing. And I just haven't seen as much progression with some of the things that I've been using. And so whether it's new DAWs, updates to DAWs, just trying to find new ways to get inspired. I know we all go through these things. So let me know, what is the things that you're looking forward to doing and what things can we see in the future? I know for me, I want to see a lot more when it comes to iOS music production. I want to see bigger DAWs. I want to see, you know, I've talked about this before. I want to see, you know, ways to manipulate the iPad even better with music production, whether it's the way they record things, the way that, you know, different interfaces are connected, whatever it is. I just want to see things get taken up a notch. And I know that I have to help the community as well to really get those things and get those ideas out there. So what are you inspired? What new apps, what new things are inspiring you? And maybe I can get back to seeing what inspires me because, you know, I've been using the same type of DAWs and the same type of workflows, trying to find something to just stir up that creativity from doing music for over the last 25 years can sometimes be hard, but I'll never give it up. And it's always been my first love. So, you know, I wanted to pose that question, figure out where things are going. How can we get to more character, to more vibe, to more essence of the music production? And where is the technology going to take us in the next 10 to 20 years? posing the question to y'all. Let's have a discussion down below and let's figure this out. I am excited for the future, but I know that right now we got to push through some of these times to trying to figure out how to make our technology work for us in the best ways possible. So leave me a comment below and let's start this discussion. And if you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe and like the video if this is something that you're into. Just wanted to bring this to y'all real quick and see what your thoughts are. Talk to y'all in a little bit. And I'm out!